Welcome to the third installment of STACKr News. What did you miss last week in YouTube web dev? In this video, I'll highlight my favorite videos from last week to help you decide which to watch, and maybe you'll discover some new videos and channels that you didn't know about. Be sure to watch to the end to check out the underrated video of the week that you need to watch. If this video helped you out, help me out by liking and subscribing. And all of the links to the videos mentioned will be in the description below. This is STACKr News. These are in no particular order. Learning Amazon Web Services can be overwhelming. In this video, DevOps Directive breaks down the 10 services you should focus on when getting started with AWS and the cloud. He'll walk you through a general web application architecture and the different AWS services that you would use to build and deploy it to the cloud. So if you've been confused by AWS, let DevOps Directive clear it up for you. Next up, Dorian Develops talks about all of the time he wasted playing video games. He says he was addicted to video games, but now he focuses his energy on things that matter and leveling up his life instead of the game. If you've never heard of the podcast Self-Taught or Not, you should check it out. You can listen to it on Dylan Israel's YouTube channel. In this episode, Dylan and Eric talk about 2020. They reflect on how their software development and personal careers were affected in 2020 and discuss what they want to accomplish in 2021. In this video, Code Beauty explains data structures in 5 minutes. Data structures are used to organize information and data in our programs. This video is an introduction to data structures, and its purpose is to explain the idea behind data structures in 5 minutes using understandable examples. Check out her other videos too, where she explains individual data structures like arrays, linked lists, stacks, queues, graphs, trees, and more. Next up, Joe at Coding Phase talks about how realistic web developer roadmaps are. Thanks for the shout out in this video. There are a few channels that do developer roadmaps that give you a really high level picture of all of the technologies involved in web development. It can be really overwhelming to see all of these technologies. But do you really need to know all of it? Check out his video to find out. Next, we have the great Brad Traversy. He's redoing all of his crash courses in 2021, and first up is the React crash course. He builds a task tracker app and teaches you all about components, props, states, hooks, working with APIs, and much more. Be sure to check that out. We had a couple of CSS battles last week. First up, Adrian Torreg challenges William Candian. Give that one a watch to see who wins. Then, for some reason, Kyle at WebDev Simplified thought it would be a good idea to challenge Kevin Powell, the CSS king, to a CSS battle. Do you want to see more of these battles? I think they're pretty entertaining, and it's nice to see different approaches to the challenges. Next up, Red Stapler shows us 7 trending JavaScript libraries in 2021 that are going to be very useful for web development. Be sure to check that out. And then we have a couple of videos from Francesco, who's been interviewing lots of great developers. In these, he interviews Jessica from CoderCoder and Kevin Powell. He has lots of other great interviews as well, so be sure to check them out. And next, Adrian Torreg shows us 10 JavaScript clean code examples and shows you how to avoid smelly code. Do you want to know how to build a shopping cart in React with TypeScript? Well, in this video from Free Code Camp, Thomas Wabenfalk teaches you how. He uses TypeScript, Material UI, Styled Components, and React Query, so be sure to check that out. If you're looking for a bit of humor, check out this video from Keep On Coding to see all of the stuff programmers don't say. And next, James Perkins shows us how to create a custom login page for next-auth, which uses Auth0. So if you want something a little more flashy than the generic login page, this video is for you. In this video, Colby Fayok teaches you how to use template literals in JavaScript. He'll break down how template literals work. He'll talk about backticks, interpolation, and tags. And we have another great video from Callie Halden. He tells us 3 skills every programmer should have. Now, if you want to have the perfect project for your portfolio, you have to watch this video from Web Dev Simplified. Creating good portfolio projects is hard since it's impossible to know what the employer is looking for. This project is very universal and shows off many great skills. It's a custom select dropdown. This is something that is not too difficult to make, but it shows that you have incredible attention to detail, which is one of the most important aspects when landing a junior developer job. So be sure to check that out. Next up, Robert Brunage shows us 10 Flutter tips to be more productive. Some of these tips apply to development in general, and some are specific to Flutter. In this 5-hour course, Python Engineer teaches you machine learning from scratch in Python. You'll implement the most popular machine learning algorithms from scratch using only Python and NumPy. That's amazing. It's now time for the underrated video of the week. You have to go subscribe to Jay Tompkins. He's amazing at CSS. In this video, he'll show you how to animate CSS custom properties to animate a background image and create animated waves. I didn't even know that this was possible before I watched his video. Go check it out. If you have suggestions for other development-related channels, please let me know in the comments below. That's going to be it for this video. Like this video to help me out, and subscribe if you haven't already for more videos like this.